Here we are in After Effects. I've got two videos on the timeline, and in order to add a transition, first I'm going to add an adjustment layer. Let's go up to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. Make sure it is above both videos. Then open Effects and Presets and search for Transform. Add the Transform to the Adjustment Layer. Then make sure you have Effect Controls panel enabled. Then move the Time Indicator to the point of the cut between the videos and move 10 frames to the left. Then create a keyframe for scale at 100 by clicking on this stopwatch icon. Then go back to the point of the cut and set scale to 300. Also make sure you uncheck Use Composition Shutter Angle and set it to 360 to add motion blur to the transition. Now press U on the keyboard while the adjustment layer is selected to see the keyframes, and we're going to bring the start of the adjustment layer to the first keyframe and also the end to the second keyframe. If you don't see the end of the adjustment layer, you can just select it, go up to Edit and select Split Layer. The shortcut is Ctrl+Shift+D and then delete the rest. So now we have this adjustment layer piece, which we're going to duplicate. So select it, go up to Edit, Duplicate, or press Ctrl+D as the shortcut. We're going to move this duplicated adjustment layer forward in time so it starts with the second video. Then select the duplicated adjustment layer and press U on the keyboard to see the keyframes. Then move the time indicator to the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer and set scale to 25. Then go to the second keyframe of the second adjustment layer and set scale to 100. Now we have all this black space that we need to hide with motion tile. So search for motion tile in effects and presets. Add it to the second adjustment layer and make sure you have the motion tile above transform for it to work properly. Then set output width and height both to 400 and check mirror edges. After that, we're going to drag and select all four of the keyframes, so right click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or press F9 as the shortcut. Then go into the graph editor, right click and make sure edit speed graph is selected. Then we're going to select the first point. You'll see the yellow handles. We're going to drag the first yellow handle all the way to the right. This one also all the way to the right. Then select the middle point again. You'll see the other yellow handle on the right side. Drag that to the left. And this one also to the left. So this is how the graph should look. Now if we exit the graph editor, make sure you move the first keyframe of the second adjustment layer one frame back to get an even smoother zoom transition. So here we got ourselves a basic zoom transition, and now let's add a warp effect to it. For this we will need a separate adjustment layer. Again, let's go up to Layer, New Adjustment Layer. And let's make this adjustment layer the size of the other two combined. So drag the start to this point and the end to the other point. Then in Effects and Presets, we're going to search for Optics Compensation and add it to the top adjustment layer. Then move the time indicator to the start of the adjustment layer over here. In Effect Controls, make sure you check Reverse Lens Distortion and create a keyframe for Field of View. Then go to the point of the cut between the videos and increase the field of view to 160 or so. Depends how much of a distortion effect you want to have. Then go to the end of the adjustment layer and set the value back to 0. Now if we press U on a keyboard to see the keyframes, drag and select all three of them, press F9 to easy ease them. And now if we do the preview, here is our warp zoom effect created in After Effects. Thank you guys for watching.